Imagine that you would like to be sure if a file exists or not inside of a server thanks to the HTTP protocol. Before we get through the solution, let me introduce myself. My name is Lorenzo Neri, and I work as integration engineer for Cap4Lab. One of the simplest methods to be used is the GET, which means that you do the HTTP request by the given URL file, and if you receive back as HTTP status code, a 200, it means that the file exists. Otherwise, it returns back a 404. Now, even though the GET method is one of the most lightweight methods provided by this protocol, there's one lighter method to be used. So, as the HTTP protocol works under two main actors, which are the client and the server, when we do a GET request from the client to the server, we receive back, of course, the request itself with a response header, but we receive the body as well. In the case of a file, the body represents the file content itself, and here we find the first limit of the GET method. Imagine that we are willing to understand if a file that weighs, let's say, 10 kilobytes, probably the request itself, it's gonna take a short time to be concluded. But imagine if things are bigger, such as like 10 gigabytes. Well, things are getting even bigger and longer in terms of time. Before we start with the approach of this new method, do not forget to subscribe to our channel. My coworkers and I are creating several contents related to MuleSoft, Cloud App, and DataWave. As I was saying before, the GET method consists of receiving back the response headers, but also the payload, which means that if we are looking for a file that weighs a lot of gigabytes, we have to wait a really long time to understand if it exists or not. Our goal is not to download the file from the server, instead is just to understand and be sure if it's there or not. So here it comes the head method. The head method provided by the HTTP protocol works similarly as the GET one. The difference is that outside of the headers given back by the response, we receive no body at all, which means that weighs even more than 10 gigabytes, even terabytes, we receive back just the status code, moreover the headers. After the theory is being explained, let's see with a proper real-time example. So I found this website that provides several file examples that could be downloaded. So the first attempt consists of copy the link of this 100 kilobyte file, open Postman, pasting the link of the file, and with the GET method, we'll see that the request concludes after 388 milliseconds, pretty fast I could say. The status is 200, which means that the file is there, and here these weird characters we are receiving back are representing the file content, the body we were talking about. Now, if I'm trying to do the same with a half gigabyte file, I paste here the link, you will see that the time is gonna be really long in order to get the request concluded. Even though we receive immediately the status code of the request, which is again 200. We are getting through 12, 14, 15 seconds, it's really long, because 512 megabytes are, of course, not 100 kilobytes. Now, the request is still ongoing, so what are we gonna do? Let me show you, canceling the request, a little difference. I go back to the 100 kilobyte file, I paste here the link, instead of GET, I will set HEAD. As you could see, it took 166 milliseconds so far. On a so small file, we don't see a huge difference in between, but let's see how things change over a huge file. So let's bring back the 512 megabyte link we paste over here, execute the head request, and here we go. We needed just 40 milliseconds, and of course the file exists. Just as conclusion for this video, if I set here a non-existing file, such like a invented name, if I send a request, I receive immediately as answer back 404. So that's it. Imagine how can you improve your own architecture of your project. Imagine if you have to check over thousands of files that weighs over megabytes, over gigabytes. Let me know what do you think about this video. See you in the next one.